Almost 50% of U.S. adults have hypertension. But what's that mean? Are we talking about heart attack risk, stroke risk, or perhaps other consequences? Elevated blood pressure is now known to affect our risk of dementia. What's more, the risk goes up with surprisingly modest elevations in blood pressure, where we might even think of high blood pressure as a cumulative risk for dementia, reflecting the total number of high blood pressure years our vascular system is subject to.
If you have early hypertension, you will have a likelihood and more chance to develop cognitive decline quickly, as compared to a normotensive person of the same age. And interestingly, they were showing also in the paper that if you have hypertension that's during your 70s, if I remember correctly, it doesn't impact your likelihood to develop dementia. So it goes back to, I think, the final point is, I think it's very important the duration. It's the chronic part of hypertension is very critical. If you have that for many years, same thing for inflammation. As you age, you have a chronic, slow, low-grade inflammation that will disrupt your vessels very slowly. Probably the same thing with hypertension. If you have too much hypertension, your arterial stiffness will be disturbed and damaged over time, and this will degrade your blood-brain barrier much faster than a normotensive person. We know there is a few studies that shows that hypertension also triggers a blood-brain barrier leakage and pericyte loss. Difficult part in clinical research is no one is hypertension and nothing else, right? Hypertensive and nothing else. There's always comorbidities, obesity, other things. So it's hard to disentangle what pure hypertension is doing to the blood vessels, because there's always other things. You can try to correct statistically with covariates and things, but it's quite hard to study.